So let us learn about the collection framework. What are collection framework? Why do we need collection framework? And what are the set of operations that we can perform with the collection framework? In Java, a collection is nothing but a framework that provides you an architecture to store and manipulate the data. What is it? You can also say that a collection framework is nothing but a container where it allows a group number of elements together in a single unit. But why do you need collection? Now, for example, when you are trying to store the data or when you write a program, you know how much the data is, what is the size of data, or how much space do you need to store the data. That is, in the case of array, you know that the array size is so much and the data that you would want to insert will be stored in that particular size. But what if you want to store the data at runtime or dynamic? And at runtime or dynamic, you are trying to change the array size, then it will increase the cost and the performance will also slow down. So in order to overcome over these disadvantages, where you would want to store the data at runtime, where you do not want to specify the size of your object, in those cases you use collection, where you create an object, the size you are not defining, you're just storing the data at runtime. So what are the kind of operations that you can perform with collection? It says that you can add or remove the object of the collections at runtime. You can go or iterate through the elements that is there in collection. And if you want to insert or delete or locate a particular element at a particular point of the collection, it is possible. That is what it says, iterating through, then retrieving, searching and deleting. All these operations are possible through your collections. Next, it says that there is a package called java.util package which holds the classes and interfaces for your collection. And this collection interface, what it does? This collection interface, it encapsulates certain other sub interfaces, and these certain interfaces are nothing but your list, queue, set and so on. Now what happens? Can you implement this particular interfaces or not? So in Java, it says that collection itself does not have as such any implementation, but you can implement one of its interfaces, or you can implement all of its interfaces. And in these interfaces, what happened? Will it allow the duplication of data? Like collection is nothing but a group of elements together. So the data or the element that you are storing in this container, will they be duplicated or can they be inserted in an order or not? That we have to decide on the basis of these kind of interfaces. Let us first consider this kind of an interface, which is a set interface. A set interface says that I will not allow any duplicacy element. If you want to store the data, store the individual data where there is no duplicacy. And the methods that are defined in this particular set are nothing but inherited from collection. So the methods here are only inherited from the collection, and it also provides a restriction that no duplicacy data will be entered. The three set of implementations, these for set, are nothing but your hash set, tree set and linked list hash set, where hash set is nothing but it allows you to store all these elements in a hash table. But it does not guarantee the order. It does not guarantee the order of the elements in which it will appear. The next one is tree set. The tree set allows you to store these elements in red black order. That is, it will again not guarantee the order, but it is better than hash set, but slower than hash set. The third one is linked list hash set. That the elements are stored in linked form in a hash table. It is still guaranteeing you a certain type of order when comparatively to your hash or tree set. The next one, let us consider a list. List, like in set, it says that duplicacy of elements are not there, but it does not guarantee the order. Whereas in case of list, It says that I don't know about the elements. I don't know if you have a duplicacy of elements, but I guarantee you the order, the sequence of elements in which it will appear. It says that whether you want to insert or delete at a particular point, I can tell where you have to go and add or delete. That is, it guarantees the order in which the element will appear. And the kind of implementation of list is nothing but you have array list or linked list. The next one is queue. What is queue? Queue says that I will keep the elements or store the elements before processing. It says that I will hold the elements before processing. I allow a FIFO method, that is first in and first out. Whereas DQ say that I will support both last in and first out and first in and first out. So we need to understand what are the kind of order or unordered way or the duplicacy of elements in case of these interfaces of collection. Now what is this map, which is a complete separate picture? It is similar to a kind of a collection, but how is it different? A map says that I will also store the data in an ordered way, but I need a key for each of the point. I need a key for every element. Next, it says that a sorted map and sorted set, these both are nothing but useful for your ascending order of elements. Therefore, a collection is nothing but which allows you to store the data dynamically or at runtime in a particular order and with eliminating the duplicacy of your data or elements.